안녕하세요, 스마트. Well. Chris Rock actually slams the Democrats for the COVID pandemic coming into America by focusing on Donald Trump. Well, let's get into it. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to another video. Welcome to Sire's Domain. And right now we are talking about Chris Rock slamming the Democrats and especially Nancy Pelosi for focusing on Trump and allowing the COVID pandemic attack America the way that it has and ravaged maybe quite a lot of people. Now, Chris Rock is someone who is a Hollywood A-lister, and unlike every other Hollywood A-lister that we know, he always speaks his mind and doesn't always conform to the narrative. And now he's come out to actually blame the Democrats. Now, when you take a look at where he's coming from, especially being somebody who is a Hollywood A-lister, we all know that the Hollywood and majority of the media, maybe over 90%, is very much liberal side-leaning, which means that they're very much in support of the Democrats. So him coming out from that side of town or from that part of the perspective or spectrum and actually coming out to blame them strictly that they're responsible for what is happening in America when it comes to the COVID pandemic is very big. And honestly speaking, it's something that somewhat has earned my respect. But there are two things I want to go into today. The first thing is, how was he able to do it without getting any backlash? Because I really tried to find out if Chris Rock got backlash for what he has said, just like Terry Crews when he came out against the Black Lives Matter, saying that Black Lives Matter should make sure that it's all Black life that matters and not just those ones that were police fatalities. Let me put it that way. So Chris Rock said this, but I am yet to see any backlash from Twitter or anybody from any angle. So how was he able to actually come out, blame the Democrats head on, and still get no backlash, neither from the right or the left? Not the Democrats, not the Republicans. And everybody is just, you know, kind of like looking at him and nodding. Well, there is two parts to the story. He not only blamed the Democrats, but he also likened Trump to a five-year-old emperor. So at this point, we're gonna go over an article that talks about what he said when he was talking to the New York Times about this whole COVID pandemic and what he said actually about Donald Trump, because he placed everyone on the firing squad. So now I'm gonna share my own thoughts with regards what he said as we go along. Please feel free to share your thoughts in that comment section below. Now, without further ado, let's get into it. Chris Rock blames the Democrat for letting the pandemic come in by focusing too much on trying to impeach President Trump, according to a new report. The comedian, 55, opened up to a wide range of interviews with the New York Times in which he touched on the current state of politics as he discussed his new show, Fargo. Now, as far as I know, when it comes to Chris Rock, he always airs his opinion, maybe from a comedy skit or maybe giving an interview. He never shies away from what he feels about anything, and anybody can get it. So he continues by saying, "So I'm like, it's all the Democrats' fault because you knew the emperor was 5 years old," Rock told New York Times. "And when the emperor is 5 years old, they only lead in theory. There's usually an adult who's like, okay, this is what we're really going to do." Now, when it comes to that, I have my reservations about when you're calling Trump a five-year-old. I mean, it makes for good humor. And sometimes I can see the point where you're coming from when you say he's a five-year-old, because sometimes his behavior can be likened to a toddler. You know, he throws temper tantrums. He says stuff that are like beyond belief, that are very laughable. Sometimes when he's talking, I'm like, this dude sounds very much like an idiot. But should you liken that person to a five-year-old? You have to remember that this person is not an emperor. He didn't get there by reason of his father being the former king and then he becomes the king because his father died. No, he got voted in. He continued, "And it was totally up to Pelosi and the Democrats. Their thing was, we're going to get him impeached, which was never going to happen. You let the pandemic come in. Yes, we can blame Trump, but he's really the five-year-old. The funny man then slammed both parties. Put it this way, Republicans tell outright lies. Democrats leave out key pieces of the truth that would lead to a more nuanced argument," he said. "In a sense, it's all fake news." So at least someone's out there who's actually very objective. Now, it is clear that he holds no reservations about the right-leaning side of things. I don't really think he's right-leaning or a conservative in any shape or form. I think he's very much a liberal and he's very much left-leaning, but he's somebody who is objective, regardless of the fact that he's left-leaning and maybe a big supporter of the Democrats because he was a big supporter of Obama and the Obama administration. But this guy never shies away from when the party that I think he supports is straying off what they should have done. I do believe that Democrats are not all at fault for what happened in America. This is a novel virus, after all. We have to always remember that. If you take a look at the last time America was struck by a novel virus in 2009, the H1N1 flu, in the space of 1 year, 60.8 million people contacted the virus. Over 274,000 people, maybe even more, according to the CDC, say maybe even up to 500,000 people
were hospitalized.
And between 12,000 to 18,000 people died from that virus. One of Obama's special advisors said that Obama put together a task force, and in as much as they were all experts, they did everything wrong. The reason why this is because it's a novel virus. And when it's a novel virus, you don't know how it's going to strike, where it's going to strike, how it's going to spread. So it's going to take you a while to actually figure out what's going on and then start finding a solution. And what this particular Obama expert said was that the only reason they were able to beat the H1N1 flu was by sheer luck. Sheer luck. So we're talking about that, and then if you compare that to what's happening with
COVID pandemic,
which is about 6 or 7 million at the moment in America, of which if you also look at their data from May to now, the death rate has been halved, and also the rate at which people are contacting this virus has also
dropped
as well. So there's a bit of progress there. Now let's treat the issue about him calling Trump a five-year-old, and this is the strategy he actually used to be able to blame the Democrats without getting any backlash. So say you're a leftist or a liberal, a big Democrat supporter, you don't take no prisoners. Anybody says anything against the left wing, you're branded anist or anism, and because they believe they hold the moral high ground, they understand a black man struggle more than a black man, and so on and so forth. So many other things, I don't want to get too much into it. So how do you place a blame on them for a certain thing that they have this whole time been blaming someone else and not get a backlash? First of all, you have to be a black person, because it's very difficult for a liberal to backlash a black person. The second thing you have to do is this: you have to make fun of the other side. You have to make fun or humiliate the other person. So by him calling Donald Trump a five-year-old, liberals who were like, how dare you try to blame the Democrats for the COVID pandemic when we all know it's the orange man's fault. And then he says, the orange man is a five-year-old. And as they're about to type on their Twitter, they're like, he's a five-year-old. He said he's a five-year-old. We can let him go. We can let him be. So basically, in order for you to actually point out the faults of the Democrats, you need to make fun of Donald Trump one way or another. And like I said before, if you're making fun of him, then what does it say about the American people themselves? Because a whole lot of them voted for Trump and not Hillary. And a whole lot of those people were blacks, Hispanics, and women who voted for Trump as well. So what does that say about those set of people? Are they a basket of deplorables or something? These are things that you need to think about. Like I said, if you point a finger at someone, think about it, the rest of the four fingers, at least three of them, are pointing back at you. Now let's go through what he said about this five-year-old. He likened him to a five-year-old emperor, and he said whatever he's doing is in theory, or whatever he's thinking is in theory, but you need grown-ups to actually take proper grown-up actions. So let's take a look at the actions that Donald Trump took. December 31st, report emerges that China is investigating an illness. In January 6th to 8th, CDC issues a series of warnings, alerts. Now, when they talk about this now, they're talking about these warnings and saying that Trump was warned, but he took no action. But let's look at the details of the warnings itself. The U.S. Center for Disease Control and Prevention issues travel warnings for Americans wishing to go to China to take extra precautions. It also says it is closely monitoring the virus, but there are no known cases in the U.S. So this was a warning to the people saying that if you're traveling to China, be careful. We don't know much about this virus, but there's a virus going on in China. There are no known cases in America. So let's not make like Donald Trump got some secret message from the CDC, some secret warning, and decided not to take precautions. January 16, CDC says U.S. will screen passengers arriving from Wuhan. That seems like an appropriate action to be taken when such a situation is happening. And as they're finding out more and more about this virus, they're taking appropriate precautions. Nobody knew how this thing spread. Remember, World Health Organization did not confirm that this thing was airborne, or nor was it an aerosol that it could spread from one person to another until later on. So they did not confirm, remember that, until later on. So this was January 16. The CDC holds a briefing on the virus, and officials say the US will start to screen passengers arriving from or connecting through Wuhan. So at this point in time, they've started screening. There was still no case in America. All right, so fast forward to January 21st. First US case confirmed. The first case is confirmed in a traveler who had recently visited China and returned to Washington State. The following day, Trump says at a news conference that the US has
the virus
totally under control. It's one person coming in from China, and we have it under control. It's going to be just fine. Now, I know a lot of people from the left will be like, how dare this president say this? How dare he say this? He said it was going to be just fine. But right now we are looking at almost 200,000 people. But guess what? It was just one person at that point in time. What did you expect the president to say? We're doomed, doomed. We're all going to die. One person has the virus in America. No, president is not going to say that. Think about it. Like, come on, man. Quoting Joe Biden. Now, it was only one person, and it's a novel virus. Nobody really knew how deadly or how bad this thing was going to become in any country. Like, when I tell you that in Australia, we didn't even start some serious lockdown till closer to March, you would be surprised. So, at this point in time, January 29,
COOF pandemic,
task force was created. Donald Trump created a task force to combat
COOF pandemic.
This is January 29th. So January 29th, U.S. coronavirus task force was created. The White House started coronavirus response task force headed by U.S. Health and Human Services Secretary Alex Azar. Dr. Fauci, the head of the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases, is appointed to the task force. Dr. Fauci will become a trusted figure in the Trump's administration's response to coronavirus. This is not the actions of a five-year-old, and this was not him theoretically approaching the virus. This was him taking appropriate action that any leader would have taken. Some of the blames that we're placing on just one man is not entirely his fault. And when you also compare the rate of maybe the deaths or the rates at which it was spreading, America didn't have it the worst in the world by any long shot. In as much as people were saying Americans had it more than any other country in terms of number, when it comes to that, you can see the left wing would be very quick to pick out numbers. But when you're talking about things that BLM is fighting about, they're quick to pick out the per capita. So let's take a look at this graph right here from the Johns Hopkins University in America. This is not a Trump graph, or this is not a Fox News graph. This is from a university in America and has been confirmed by so many other sites as well. So according to this graph, you can see that the rate, it's higher in countries like Belgium, UK, France, Italy, Netherlands, Spain, Sweden, Mexico, Canada, Brazil. Somewhere these are the death rates of all other countries. When you take a look at the US death rates, it was 6% as of May. Fast forward to August, September, it has come down to 3%, which is still below these countries that I have mentioned. And we're talking about per capita, we're not talking about the full numbers. So there are actions that are being taken by America to actually combat this particular pandemic, and these are facts, or at least these are documents or data that has been documented by experts that are not any party leaning or politically leaning. So I just wanted to make this video about Chris Rock and what he said. I do agree with him that instead of there to be a bipartisanship, and if there was a bipartisanship in America, I don't think they would be facing this much problem if the parties decided to put the people first and say, let's forget about the election. We can campaign about the election, but let's come together and actually help the people out instead of trying to do things that would actually put down maybe the president who's trying to help. He was trying to help and still is trying to help. Also, you have to bear in mind that America is a republic state, not a Republican state, a republic state, which means that every governor is also in charge of their state. And so even if the federal government can propose ways of combating this, it's up to the state governors to actually decide whether they want to follow the guidelines from the federal bureaus or from the federal bodies like CDC and what have you. It's up to the governors and the mayors to actually follow the policies and the rules that have been put in place or actually use theirs. So in as much as you want to blame the five-year-old, you also need to blame the governors as well and not just put all blames on one person. So I think Chris Rock did very well by blaming them. And also probably when it comes to how Trump approached this, I don't think that he was fully correct because Trump approached it as a matured person. But the things that Trump said, you could also liken to a five-year-old sometimes. But anyway, those are my thoughts with regards to his own comments. Please feel free to share your thoughts in that comment section below. I hope you guys have enjoyed the video. And if you did, please feel free to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, ding that bell for notification, and all that good stuff. Now, before I get out of here, I really want to quickly remind you guys to keep on looking out for each other and look out for each other. Peace. And Sire's out.